Good morning, students. In the last class, we have learned how we can work with the file and folders, like copying, moving a file and folder, and also how to delete a file and folder and restoring that particular deleted file and folder. In this class, we will learn how we can change the name of an existing file or folder. So for that, first I am going to click on File Explorer button from the taskbar. It will help me to open the File Explorer window as I have shown in the previous classes. So this will give me the quick access view. From there we can see only the frequent file and recent folders. So I'm choosing this document folder, and there I made this assignment folder. So how we can rename a file and folder? Just you look at the steps. Now suppose this assignment folder I have made here, and in this English folder, this folder I made. Now I want to change the name of this folder to Bengali. How we can rename it? First thing is you have to click on this file and folder. Then you will click on the rename option from the ribbon. Then and there, this blue bar around the text will come, and then you will, that means the text has been selected. Next you will press backspace button or delete button from the keyboard, and then type the new name. Okay, so in this way we can rename a folder using the ribbon. Another steps are there, like if you want, you can use F2 button from the keyboard. That is also doing the same. It is also used to change the name of an existing file or folder. So if I am now selecting this file and folder, first I am selecting here and then pressing F2 button from the keyboard. Same, this blue bar has been showing here around the text. Now you will just type the new name, like if I want to change it to Hindi. So rename done. Also you can use another process, that is right click and then click on the rename option from this list. So either you can select rename option from the ribbon, okay, or you can use F2 button from the keyboard, and also you can use right click and then press on rename option. So this is the steps for changing a name of an existing file and folder. Now next is how we can search a file and folder. Like sometimes it might be happen, like we can't remember the location where I saved some files. So in such case, if you want to save our time and effort, we can quickly search the folders or files using this search box. Where we will get that options and how to do the steps, just I'm showing everyone, look at the screen. So first you have to open that particular drive there you want to search for. So like I'm going to D drive, there I want to search something. And here different folders, you can see many folders are there. Now if I want to save my time and I want to just quickly get a folder or file, so for that what I have to do, I will type that particular folder name or file name in the search box that is present next to the address bar. This is the address bar and the search box. This is the search box. Here, this is the search box. There we will write the chapter name or the folder name or file name that you are searching for. Suppose I am searching for chapter 2. So if I want to get quickly, I will write here and then press on enter. Then and there, see whatever data related to chapter 2 it is showing here. You can easily can see, you will In this way, you can save your time and effort, and you can quickly getting the file and folders. So same process for the files also. See here, files also showing related to chapter 2. So in this way, we can rename and we can search the file and folders. So for searching, we will use the search box just next to the address bar. Now let's discuss about the more features of this file explorer window. We have already seen some of the very basic features of this window. Now if I'm talking about this home tab, see there is one option, new item. This new item will help me to create any type of file or folder. So if you're clicking on this arrow, see folder, you can make shortcut by using this option, you can create, and also the different types of file. So I'm choosing from here what file. So then and then you can see one file has been created. You can give any name to it. I am giving the name worksheet 2. So my file has been created. So in this way also you can make a file or folder. And by right clicking, creating a file or folder, I think you know that in the last video I have shown you, right click then new, and then this option will help you to create either folder or file. Now look at this option, properties. Suppose you want to check the version, size, or when the folder or file has been created. This properties, if you want to check, then what you will do, you will first select that folder or file, like PDF, this PDF I have been selected, and then I'm clicking on properties. So then and there it will show me that which type of file is this, where I have saved this file and folder, what is the size of this, when I have created this folder or file. Every information we can get from this properties options. So sometimes it might require, like we want to check the size of any application or software or any file, any type of file, we want to check the size of it or the location where I have saved it, I can find it. So for that reason, we can use this properties option. That's it. Now here is select all options. If you are selecting this, so all the files and folders will be selected. You can also use a shortcut, that is Control A. If you are pressing Control A from the keyboard, it will also help you to select all the files and folders present in the current window. So this is about the different features that is present in this window under Home tab. Open, it will help you to open selected file, whatever you want. You can open whatever folder you will choose. Suppose you can double click on that, you can open it. By double clicking on that particular folder, you can open it, and also you can select and then click on the open. So that's about the Home tab. So today up to this only. Again in the next class, I will discuss more features that present in this File Explorer window. Different tabs are there. We will discuss in the next class.